All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Trying to break things down on the West Coast out here, folks. We got some stuff to talk about. You know, I've been doing a lot of different posts lately. Been talking about all these duck hires. We just got off the Alamo Bowl. We'll have recruiting in the future here, but it's bowl season. Right now, I'm watching Wisconsin beat ASU. Wow, the Pac-12, man, just doing it again for us here. Going another ofer. Brutal. Got me starting to think about it. I was doing a show the other day with a guy from the East Coast, and we were kind of talking about big picture college football stuff, and we started going off on this, playoff idea and what to do with the playoff, and if it's a four-team playoff or a six-team playoff or an eight-team playoff or a 12-team playoff, whatever the heck team playoff you look at, you know, however many teams you put in it. But what would that idea look like? And I do think this is a year where it really makes sense to kind of break this down a little bit and look at what could it be. You know, I know that this format that we have right now is already on the books for another couple, 5-10 years or whatever. But I think they're going to change it. I think there's a lot of pressure to change it and to kind of bring some sort of a semblance of normalcy to this thing and give it a real, true playoff. And so the 12-team playoff started getting kicked around. Again, historically, I always thought the 6-team playoff was the best because you had your five champions out of your five conferences, automatic qualifiers. You keep your championship game. You have your regular sort of situation where you have your playoff game and you have your championship game. But your top two could take bye weeks. You could put those top two at bye weeks, play their game, play the next game. So they don't have to play the two games if they went out. And another team would have to win three games, you know. And but I've always thought that was a great system because you keep your college football in line. Your regular season is still basically a playoff. Every game still counts. You're going to have to get to the end. You have to win your championship game. So you're like this year where you'd have Alabama in Georgia, where Alabama at the very end goes and wins the SEC championship. Now Georgia would be out after being number one the whole year, right? So those games really matter, and those games would continue to matter. And so I've always liked that 6-team idea, you know. And then a lot of people are talking about the 8-team playoff. I like the 8-team playoff as well, where you've got your 5 automatic qualifiers, you've got your 4 bids out front, or 3 more bids out front that you can kind of work with, and again, you're talking about your guys on the outside, like a Notre Dame this year, like a Cincinnati, but you're also talking about that third team from the SEC, right, or that second team from the SEC, that other team from the Big Ten or whatever. When you're talking about trying to get the rankings in and trying to get the top 10 or top 8 teams in from just the ranking point of view, it can get a little dicey. So start talking about that, right? 8-team playoff. That looks great. And then you start talking about the 12-team playoff. 12-team playoff starts to get a little insane for me because of the timing it's going to take to get all these games done. I'm a big believer in not trying to take up the entire month of December. I don't think these guys should be playing 16 games. And I do think that they should have Christmas off. I think that historically, family should be able to get together and be able to have at least those 3 or 4 days of Christmas time, be able to have that off, be able to get back with their families and go do their thing. It's also that early recruiting season time is a tough one. And so you'd have these playoff games maybe kind of affecting that sort of time frame of the early recruiting or early signing period. So maybe you have to push the early signing period back a little bit or do whatever you're going to do. But so here's my idea. This is this 12-team idea. There's a variety of different ways to do it. But I think if you had 12 teams, you should go with the 5 Power 5 conferences should each get 2 representatives. Now, this is, again, a little outside-the-box thinking. Most people would think you just take the regular top 12 teams in the rankings, and whoever's ranked 13th is out. I do think that's a tough one because that's, again, just the way the ranking system works is not perfect, not ideal. But here's this the way I look at it, and this is just my perspective, right? You want to try to win your conference, obviously. But the other team that doesn't win the conference still has something to say here. They're still a great team. They've gone through their whole conference. Maybe it's a Pac-12 situation where you have a North and South. This year it'd be Oregon in the North, Utah in the South. Obviously, Utah's the winner. The way it happened this year, beating Oregon twice in the last 2 weeks, the last 3 weeks, obviously. But the way that I see it working out is if you did this with the 12-team playoff and you guaranteed two teams from each division that would get in, you still have two at-large bids. Your two at-large bids could easily be this year Notre Dame and Cincinnati, and then everybody else gets in. Okay. Now, there's still going to be some issues there where you have maybe a team that is outside of the second place team in their conference, like a Michigan State, but they think they should be in this conversation because Michigan State's ranked 10th right now. So again, just playing that out, how that works, right? Big picture, I think this would be really fantastic because one of the key things I think to get the most viewership for this team, and again, I think this college football has increased in value so much and popularity so much. This thing is a gigantic money pit, right? And if you built this thing the right way, had Caesars in on it, had MGM on it, had ESPN or Fox and everything, bidding war for all this sort of stuff, there is major amounts of money that is going to be generated by this thing, even more than you have right now. So, couple questions here. Do you keep the bowls? Well, if you're doing a 12-team playoff, you're going to have to keep some semblance of the bowls. There's up to almost, 40 bowls now? So you're going to have to keep some semblance of the bowls. But the bowls are only for teams, basically, with 8 wins, maybe some 9-win teams, or 10-win teams if there's a bunch of teams that are winning and getting into this 12-team playoff. But your bowls, your high-end bowls, your New Year's 6 bowls, all that sort of stuff, can all be incorporated into the playoff system, okay? Kind of like they do now, where they are on a rotation. You could set the thing up and have everybody doing their thing and still have it be a regional thing if you wanted to, Big Ten, Pac-10, or Pac-12 in the Rose Bowl, or, you know, ACC, SEC, Sugar Bowl, or whatever the case may be. So I like this idea, 12-team playoff, right? Here's how this would work. Your top 4 teams would get a bye week the first week. I'm a big believer in trying to get this thing going quickly. So I like the idea of if you keep your conference championship game, which again is on the table for me, if you guarantee two teams in from each conference, you don't need the conference championship game. Now, if the conference championship game is something that is making these conferences a lot of money and it's a big deal and it proves this champion, well, then that's fine. Take, for example, the situation you're going to have with some of these conference championship games where, you know, you've got this weird situation like you have where, you know, Alabama beats Georgia. And, you know, maybe in a modern outlook on college football, you're like, well, that's not that big of a deal. But in years past, it'd be a huge deal, right? So it's just one opportunity more to have another loss, basically is what I'm saying. So do conferences want to get away with that? If they would do away with that, that'd be fantastic, right? So you get this thing started even earlier. But if you still have to go through that conference championship week, you still do it on that first week of December. And so you can have your week one of these possible matchups be that second week of December, December 12th, let's say. You would have the top 4 teams have a bye, so you would have 5 through 12 play each other, right? This year, you know, the way that it was seeding and everything else, I kind of made a mock of the whole thing. There'd be some pretty cool games in here. But you'd have like a, you know, 5-12 seed. You know, the 6-8 or the 7-8 play each other, the 9-10 play each other, the 6 play the 11. The winners of those games would all play those byes for that second week, right? So then on the 12th of, or on the 18th of December, you would have all the people waiting in that bye, those first top 4 seeds waiting for the winners of that first week. Winners of those games go play, and you play a final 4 on New Year's Day. You got a little chunk of time in there with Christmas, and you got the other bowl games happening at that time, Sarsaparilla Bowl and everything else for the 6-6 teams. Everything else is cool. Have your final 4 on, you know, New Year's Day would be fantastic, you know, and that could be like a Rose Bowl, Sugar Bowl, Orange Bowl type of thing. And then you have your championship game a week later from there, or 10, 12 days, whatever the case may be after that. This year, it'd be look a little different, though, right? Because right now, you're at the end of the year, the rankings were Bama, Michigan, Georgia, Cincy, top four. Those would be the byes. You had Notre Dame, Ohio State, Baylor, Ole Miss, Oklahoma State, Michigan State, Utah, Pitt. Well, the way I looked at it is you would have the automatic qualifiers going there is a little bit differently. So a team like Oregon technically would be in, even though they are like 14th in the rankings, if you had it that way. If you had it the other way, where maybe you could do something around those at the end, if they didn't really work the way, like Oregon, for example, who had lost their last game, maybe they get switched out for another team, whatever the case may be. But it could be something as easy as, you know, you have to kind of find your way in, right? And so, you know, for me, the way I look at the seeding is you'd have to kind of take your conference champions or whoever is the best team in that conference and whoever is that second best team in the conference. So, yes, you would have Michigan in on the top four, but you'd also have Ohio State in. You would have Baylor and Oklahoma State be in. And you would have Utah and Oregon in for the Pac-12. You'd have Wake Forest and NC State in. But you could also have a question mark about like a team like Ole Miss, right? So because you already have Bama and Georgia in, is there room for a third SEC team? Well, this year, because you had Notre Dame and Cincinnati in, probably there's not room for a third team. But then you took a look at how Oregon played at the end of the year. Do you switch out Ole Miss for Oregon or something? There's all these kind of different scenarios out there. So I just think it's a fun conversation to have. If you got ideas about it, shoot it in the chat or whatever. But I really like the idea. I've always been a proponent of the six-team playoff. The top two get a bye, and it just shortens things up. It goes from there. And everybody gets a seat at the table, all five conferences, plus one. So the SEC could have another one, or the independent would have the one. As an automatic qualifier. The 8-team playoff I really like as well. 10-team playoff, 12-team playoff, whatever the case may be. I do think they're going to expand it. I just hope they preserve the bowl half, at least for all the teams that aren't in it that are still winning teams. The bowls are still very profitable for a lot of those teams and a lot of those conferences and for those sponsorships. People are still interested in that. So I think that's still a positive thing to try to hold on to that as much as you can and then really try to incorporate all these other bowls into the playoff system and try to keep these things rolling. All right, guys. Thanks for watching Sport Chat 503. Adios.